intellectually gifted Maid of Honor to the beautiful, beautiful bride. You know, I really can't believe that this day is actually here. We've been planning for about a year and a half. Every day, via email, on the phone, text message, Facebook, whatever you have, might have. And the execution was perfect. It's everything that Jan and I imagined. The ceremony, beautiful. This venue, take a look at the place, gorgeous. The bride and groom, well, have you ever seen a more handsome couple? Take a look at the mothers and grandmothers, ladies, just beautiful, beautiful. I might have you stand at my wedding. And the wedding party, wow, guys, we are ridiculously, ridiculously good looking. High five all around, everyone. As for the rest of you. You know, Chad and I have known each other since elementary school. The church that we were in today, we actually went to that elementary school, you know, back a few years ago. And Jack was in the same grade as my older brother. We would walk home from school, I would head to my family's restaurant, and she would walk home. But back then, you know, we didn't really chat so much. I think we got to know each other more as we attended these Vietnamese prayer services on a monthly basis, attended each other's birthdays, first communions, things of that nature. And, you know, we went through a lot together. You know, Jam, being as beautiful as she is today, she was just as beautiful growing up. We both had these giant Coke bottle thick glasses. I swear our prescriptions were so strong we could see through walls. And we had these just terrible, terrible perms. Just our bangs, not our hair, that our mother forced upon us. And we were both such metal mouths in high school. That's right, guys. These Vanna White mouths aren't all natural. You know, Jan would get basil stuck around her teeth every time we ate pho, and I would have pepper flakes stuck in my teeth every time we had to come. Good times, my friend, good times. You know, it would be impossible for me to overstate my respect for my best friend. Tony, I hope you know that she is a decent, true, and honest individual as I have ever met. She tells you how it is, and is one of the reasons why we all love her so much. She is a woman of few words, and there is a matter-of-factness about her that is just so refreshing. And as you always say, she never gives you an inch. And I hope that never changes. I have witnessed Jan assist friends and family in moments of need. For example, when she was with my brother in Phuong. Well,